Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today I'm going to show you how to apply a paper cutout effect to your images, which comes in handy when you want to jazz up your content. Here's a simple slide where I've added a character and a background from the content library. And on the second slide, I've added a paper cutout effect to the same image. Here's another example of the paper cutout effect. Keep in mind that all the resources that I used are available in the iSpring Suite content library, so you don't have to go digging around on the interwebs to find all this cool stuff. Okay, so let me show you how to quickly apply this effect to your images. First, what we're going to do is trace a line around this lady. So I'll just go to the Insert tab, and then select the Freeform shape. I'm just going to do a quick and dirty outline here, but you're obviously going to want to be a little more careful. If you want to do a more accurate outline, like the one on the second slide, one trick you can use is pressing Windows R on your keyboard and typing main.cpl. That'll take you to the mouse options, and you can slow down your pointer speed for more accuracy. If your computer supports a stylus or touch pen, that's another way to improve your accuracy. Plus, the good news is that if you make a mistake, you can press backspace on your keyboard to go back to the previous point in your cutout. Okay, so I'm just going to finish whipping out this outline, and now that it's a shape, I can right-click and set the fill to white and the outline to white. And we'll go to the format options and add a little drop shadow. You can just pick one of the presets and adjust it to your liking if you want. Now let's right-click and send it backward behind the lady again. And there it is! Plus, you can apply this effect to different PowerPoint shapes and any object or image you like. Thanks for watching! Now you're cut out to use cutouts. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.